Every one of us are going to be blessed. Amen. Those who are discouraged are going to be encouraged. Those are in need. Before we leave this place, abundance will be our portion.
Amen.
We ask, we believe that our prayer has been answered.
Amen.
Because we ask in the name that above every other name. And let people call that name
Jesus.
Let us be seated. We are seated already. God is good. God is good. Oh. I say God is good
all the time.
And all the time. I want to take this opportunity to thank the Lord on behalf of all Nigeria ministers here, especially the Council of Nigeria Ministers. We thank God on behalf of this organization. I want to take this time to thank God on behalf of the president of the organization. This is happening under your watch. We give God the glory on your behalf. We believe that the best is yet to come.
Yes.
Say amen.
Amen.
I want to thank all of you that came. The Lord will visit us today.
Amen.
Greeting for my wife. She's not here. There's been any time we come here. She's always with us. But today, my wife is away to Texas. But this is actually saying her own greeting. By God's grace, Jesus tarry next year. He's going to be there with us.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
I want to thank the Lord on behalf of the Pastor Bill, who came to represent. He should not respect my word, represent God Family Church.
Amen.
That's very, very important. Praise the Lord. Now, the theme for this is the maturity and the signs of maturity in the kingdom. The maturity and the signs of maturity in the kingdom. That is the theme of these lectures. We are going to have a dialogue. We're going to be asking questions with their time. According to the time written here, we're supposed to finish by 2:30. I don't know, but I have two sessions. And each will last like 40 or 45 minutes each. So we can have time to eat. Amen? This year I'm going to eat. Praise the Lord. God is good. Now if you see the file that is in your hand, you are going to see behind that there is a clean sheet for you to write. Because these are just outline. And this outline consists about almost 30 references. But we're going to be ministered to you. Some of the lectures is not, some of the lectures not in that outline, so write them down. Write them down. I was told that this is going to be live, so a little bit nervous, but pray for me. You pray for me. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
You see, the theme of that is called Pastors, Plural, and Leaders. That is the theme in your hand. Pastors and what?
Leaders.
Listen, we're supposed to govern this, the church of God supernaturally. The church is a supernatural entity. We, as a pastors and leader, supposed to pastor the church of God what? Supernaturally. Because the church, listen to me, is not an organization. The church is an organism. You understand what I'm saying? The church was not the product of church doctrine. The church is the product of resurrection power. It was when Jesus arose from the grave that he started the church. The church is not the product of theology. Theology is good, I got a couple of degrees. But the church is a product of demonstration. When there is no power, the church is not church. The church, three things so far. Amen. The church, number one, is not an organization. The church is an what? Organism. Amen.
Yes.
The church is not the product of church doctrine. The church is a product of resurrection power. Are you hearing me? And that the church. So therefore, the church must be covered what? Super what? Save me, somebody.
Amen.
You understand what I'm saying? Now, there are 195 countries in the world. I Googled them. But I think it's more than them, but that's what I Googled. Now, listen to me. Out of this 195 countries in the world, Israel, the Jewish people, are you listening to me? They are supernatural.
Glory.
Because Israel were established by God. Are you hearing me? It was this year that the capital city of Israel shipped to Jerusalem.
Hallelujah.
Yeah? Listen, the Jewish, the population, they are no more than California. But no country in this world can conquer them. No country can conquer Israel. If you agree with me, say amen.
Amen.
The only reason why God bless America is because America backed Israel. In any country, God said in Genesis chapter 12, if you bless them, you are going to be blessed.
Yes.
If you curse them, you are going to be cursed. Because they are supernatural. They cannot be conquered. Jesus is coming back, and Jesus is going to land in that place. You surprised that America is not the capital city of the world. Is Israel. Can I have amen to that?
Amen.
So what do you mean about Israel? Now they are what? Super what?
Natural.
Well, let me tell you about church. Listen, church is not only supernatural, we are also glorious. There's something about church that's peculiar than Israel. Say amen.
Amen.
Ask me why.
Why?
You would ask me now, like a bounty. Ask me why now?
Why?
So, we are in the midst of our colleagues.
Yes.
Whatever, so, something we say here, we can't even say in the church. Some of the things you are going to hear today, if you put it down in the church like that, they will fire you. They will fire you. So you have to open your hand now to the man. You understand what I'm saying now? You know why the church is glorious? You know why the church is glorious? In this world, I'm not on the scripture. In this world, there are three elements that control this world. Three elements that control this world. Because the world is natural. This world is controlled by them. How many elements? It's four.
Four.
I mean, I want to say four. I want to say percentage.
Four.
It's four, not three.
Four.
And those elements cannot control the source. That is why you are glorious. Number one, in this world, we are controlled by time. Sir? By time. In the science, we say whatever goes up, nothing to up.
Come down.
The only thing that will not come down is your age. It's going to. So we control by time. Right? Number two, we control by energy. I think I'll share with you today that when you grow up, you don't have energy, you have wisdom. When you are young, you have energy, no wisdom. No. So we control in this world by what?
By
the third monster. That controls the third one, the third element that controls space. This is after here and after not in the house. The only one place at the same time, unless you are rich, I know you are not rich, I'm just saying. By space, right? That's number three. Number four, matter. All the things that science has given matters.
Number three.
Number four, matter.
Space.
The first matter. Second one, energy. Third one, space. Fourth one, matter. All these are elements that control this natural world, but not the church. Genesis chapter 1 is a preparation. That you are going to go deep today. Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, it said, in the beginning God created heaven and earth. Verse 2 said, it said, there was darkness and void all over. Is that not the Bible?
Yes.
Listen, in the beginning. Yes. Say that with me.
In the beginning.
What you are saying, you see that some people don't understand and say, oh, you hate me. Don't say in the beginning.
In the beginning.
Pastor, you did not say the beginning of God. He said, in the beginning, God created.
Mm.
Not in the beginning of God. God is the beginner of the beginning.
Mm.
God has no beginning. Mm. Amen?
Amen?
Listen to this, like a proverb. There was a time that there was a time. There was a time. There wasn't time, but there was God.
Yes. Yes.
He said, in the beginning, God. Whenever the beginning, the time starts with God. I'm going somewhere like that, right? What I'm saying? So there was a time that God came down from the corridor of north. God was in the north. He came down from the north. He came down to the corridor of time. He said, let there be. I'm talking about your father, that is your God. That is why nobody can write off. Nobody can come out to serve. Because you didn't listen to God. Right? Yes. So God came from the north, according to Psalm 75, verse 7 and 8. God is living in north. According to Isaiah, chapter 14, verse 13, God is living in north. So he came down from the corridor of time. He said, in the beginning, the back of time, right? In the beginning, time, right? Created energy, heaven and earth, space, darkness and void, matter. All start with God. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
And that is God. So we, as a pastor and leader, we represent that God. So you cannot be stopped by time. You cannot be stopped by energy. You cannot be stopped by space. You cannot be stopped by matter. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You represent God that cannot be stopped. That is why, in the work of God, you don't get tired, you'll be fired. When you know your purpose, all those four elements will be working for you. God can use you for 8, like desire. He can use you for 80, like Moses. That's not God's problem. Stop talking about your age. Age is a matter of mind. If you don't mind, it doesn't matter. Let's talk about what God wants to do. God wants to do something. We are not living here the way we came in. We go in fire. It's only in your church. They will put down you, not here. The purpose of this organization is to encourage you, to let you know that God loves you. Someone said that with me, God loves
you.
So what do we ask for, Father? What control the world? Four things that control the world. What are those things? Those things cannot control what?
You
cannot control the church. Amen. Now, I said there's something about the church that is peculiar than Israel. Do I tell you that thing? Do I say Israel, they were all super natural. They cannot be conquered. But the church is also supernatural and glorious. The church is glorious. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 27. He said the church is glorious. Pastor, you know why the church is glorious? Ask me why, church.
Why,
people, we are trying to dialogue. Listen, the church, hallelujah, is the only body that Christ dwell in. 1 Corinthians 3:16. 1 Corinthians 3:16. He said, then, don't you know that your body, come on, is the temple of Holy Ghost that spoke of dwelling in you. You are different than the world. So if the Spirit of God is you, make you glorious. In your home, you see, I get one church, you don't share the way. You see, the only thing that conquers people is still glorious. Ocean forces, saying that people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge, not because of wish.
Right.
You are saying that you pass on time because I want to. Amen. Listen, who are the nature that is supernatural? Who are those nations?
Yes, Israel.
Israel.
Yes.
They cannot be what?
Conquered.
Now, what makes us peculiar? We are supernatural.
Glorious.
How does glorious?
Because
what? The Spirit of God.
Yes.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
So when they ask the late Lincoln to contest for presidency, I got the high calling. You vote for me for every 4 years. What of the money I cannot vote me out? See me somewhere. So we have the high calling in life. is the problem with the church is leadership. And that's why we are here. I'm not going to join you. I'm going to join this. Say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The second thing I want to do about open speech. Tell me how to say it. I want you to write it after that. You ready? You ready for this? What do you have so far now? Number one, what do you have so far? Talk about what do you have as supernatural?
Number one.
Eh? Time? Time? What happened to time? Smart?
We are not going to talk
about time. You're limited by time,
energy,
space,
matter.
Listen, you can tell people what God will do in your life and in church without a doubt. People of God don't do that. They say you are crazy. But only the church. Because God say this. And it's done. Because you don't control by this element. We are troubled when we reduce the knowledge of the church to the knowledge of book. Then we are in trouble. We need to be able to hear God's voice.
Yes.
Not human voice. Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. God is so good. Any question on that so far before we go to the next session? This is my open speech for you. Any question so far? If there's no question, let me say this.
Not yet.
There are four ways, thank you, sir. There are four ways to study the Bible. If you don't study the Bible in these four ways, Bible becomes story. Story about Abraham, about Isaac, about story. Bible is not story.
When there's no power, listen. The church is not church.
Listen.
The church.
Four ways to study the Bible. If you get that four ways, Bible becomes the sword of the Spirit.
The church is not organism.
It becomes the sword of the Spirit.
Amen.
Not story.
The church is not a product.
Say amen.
Of the church.
Number one, you'll be able to study the Bible to find out who Jesus Christ is. What he is, where he is now, and who he is. Jesus, listen, is the subject of the Bible. He said that by himself. Hey, you study the Bible to find out who Jesus Christ is and where he is right now. According to John chapter 5. John chapter 5, verse 39. John 5, 39 says, you sign the scripture. You think you're going to have eternal life. He said, all these scriptures are talking about me. Jesus is the subject of the Bible. When you study your Bible, you are looking for who Jesus Christ is and where he is right now. I come to 1 John chapter 4, verse 17. 1 John 4, 17. He said, as he is right now, so we are in this world. That's what the Bible said. You study the Bible to find out who Jesus Christ is. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
If you don't do that, it becomes stone. Say it to somebody.
Amen.
That's number one. Number two. Ask me why we need to study about that. Ask me why.
Why?
Because your identity stems from his reality. Who you are stems from him. If you don't know who he is, now we are nobody. Your identity stems from his reality. So you study the Bible to know who he is. You remember, he told people, he said, who do people say I am? Only Peter get the message. He said, thou art Christ, right? The son of living God. He told Jesus, I said, don't say it, no, don't say it. Why? Because I'm not yet alive. I'm not yet conquered death. I'm going to conquer death. If I come back, then you can tell the church, the people that are Christ. So we study the Bible to find out who Jesus Christ is. He said, upon this I will build my church.
Yes.
Hey, the gate of hell. 2011, I was going to Seattle, from a seminar in Seattle. I sat down with a man, half women, half men, half female. And he sat down with me. And he's going to the same place I'm going to. But I learned that Jesus has been my church. Come on, the gate of hell. Look at me today too. The woman or the man, I don't know who he is, two in one, is on a mission. But it cannot conquer you.
Yeah.
if you know who Jesus Christ is.
Hallelujah.
As I would study the Bible. In 2010, I was going to Spain. And that place, the church was so big. The choir master was a wizard. Also, no pioneer. I was there to minister. Look at me today here. He said, I will build my church. The gate of hell cannot prevail. Listen, the church belongs to Jesus by ownership. The church belongs to you and I by still worship. The church belongs to the people by membership.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. What have we studied about? Number one, to find out who Jesus Christ is. Do you know the hall of faith in the Bible? That chapter, Hebrew chapter 1?
Never.
All those. Do you know that? That is not our example. No. Those people are, Abraham is the father of faith, but Abraham is not the author and the finisher of faith.
No.
Jesus is the author. Praise the Lord. If you study that Hebrew 11, the last verse, verse 40, he said, Hebrew 11, 40, he said, there is something that God is having said. He will not do it until we are present. And yet, you want to copy Isaac, Abraham? No, they are not our example. Hebrew 12:2 said, looking unto Jesus, the author, finisher of faith. It is a looking unto Abraham. Jesus is the subject of the Bible. That's why I quote it back, because what I'm teaching today is not anybody's church doctrine. So don't get angry. Amen. Your church doctrine cannot save you. Jesus is our Savior. So number one. And number two, if you don't study Jesus on the Bible, Bible just say what? His story. His story. And then, but when you study Jesus on the Bible, that's because sword of the Spirit. Number two, you study Bible. You need to find out the Bible. Who are you in Christ? Who are you in Christ? Because if you don't know who Jesus Christ is, you won't know who you are. Babala, Babala, forget the Bible. Who was that Osho? Who was that Osho? Who that Osho? Matthew 28:18. He said, all power. Eh? How said it? All power. Where? In heaven? It is as a demon to us. It is not to me. All power. So if this one got on the power, Satan has zero power.
Yes.
Zero power. You remember, Pastor, that is a mental reality. When you need to beat up our money, it can't be anything because all power belongs to Jesus. But now I won't go there.
That's
the question
of advice. Yeah. You need to tell us.
Yeah, I will tell you what. Reason we study Bible to know you are in Christ. But that's a gentleman who do this. I get we know that. The third reason. Study Bible. I know I'm just surprised. I'm not even going to preach. The third reason we study Bible to know what Jesus Christ has done for us. The work is finished. It's finished. Somebody said Fileto. It's finished. John 19:30, Jesus said, it is finished. He didn't say, I'm finished. He didn't say, it's going to be finished. He said, it is finished. Because he had all is done, is finished.
Amen.
So you have to minister with peace. Matthew 11:28, he said, come unto me, while you are happy, I will give you what? Rest. Otherwise, we are going to stretch out. And this one, oh my God, what? Rest. The only people that will not leave you is your family. Then we come, then we go. Rest.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I remember 5 years, I think 5 years ago, I woke up one day. I was looking for glasses to read my Bible. President, I look for this glass for 1 hour. And Satan said, yeah, you know that. Yeah. No, that glass is in my head, you know. I put my head. When the devil said that, okay, come on, he said that. Holy Ghost said, I give you a glory, man. I can quote the Bible 100, I give God the glory. Just to let the devil know he's a liar. Somebody said, that's a liar. Whatever you face now, how we do it?
Definitely. Yes. No doubt.
Thank you, Papa. That's two reasons. The third reason. The fourth one now. You have to study the Bible to examine what the Holy Spirit can do through you. God only can do
to establish.
That's the fourth one.
Examine
what the Holy Spirit can do through you. Listen. It's not English speaking, I cast out devil. No. When you go to the nation, that day, you cast out devil in the school of neology. Amen. God called you and I. Amen. Because we are not qualified. So you can qualify us, you can receive all the glory. God called the qualified. So God can take all the glory. So those hands will what? Can't do it. What about the protection now? Because some of the people you are pastor, you can get what is green ticket. No! It's not a matter of a school degree. It's a matter of the anointing. Isaiah 10:27. Isaiah 10:27. He said the yoke shall be destroyed by the anointing. It's anointing. I don't say you not study, I don't say you not read book, I'm just saying that don't let that to be your barrier. God will do it. You read the word to examine what the Holy Ghost can do in your life. So it's not about you, it's about me. Say amen.
Amen.
Oh, how can I tell people? Let enough that introduction. Let's go to the test now. Do you have questions so far?
No.
No, sir.
No, sir. But don't stop.
Not yet.
Don't stop.
Not yet. So God will have glory.
Hallelujah.
Now the test. He said the difference between the four kinds, three kinds of leadership. You see that?
Yeah.
Three kinds of leadership. You see that? You see the spirit of Korah? You see the spirit of Saul?
Yeah.
You see the one that called himself, and see the one that people call, and you see the people that God called. Which area are we at? That is the subject of matter. This, you cannot grow church if we don't grow. Right?
Yes.
You cannot grow church if you don't grow. Amen? I have an opportunity a little bit to travel. I see, hey, Papa, there's a church. Church. Thank God for church. In Nigeria, almost every street is church. Well, it's better than no church. If it's gonna be like that, it's not no church. I see some churches is bigger than this hotel.
Mm-hmm.
Huge.
Some churches, people have to, otherwise you will miss your road.
True or false?
Yes.
You don't have to have true or false?
True.
Big church. Big one. They are long, huge, tall.
But only if you are deep.